Welcome back to Bulldog Weekly, Season 8, Episode 4. I'm Jake.
And I'm Katie.
In this week's episode, we'll look behind the music, get an interview with a new teacher, and look at this year's senior class officers.
Woohoo! But before we get to that, here's Mr. Duvall and Mr. Carrig with the week ahead of school and sports. Take it away.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Rundown. Today is October 20th, Sunday, and this is homecoming week. This is pretty exciting for our students. So there's a lot going on, so buckle up. Monday in the Bulldog Block is Mentor Day. We'll be scheduling students for the rest of the week. For the theme for the day for homecoming, it is Pajama Day. Fun, which for most students feels like every day. On Tuesday, the 22nd, for Bulldog Block, we have the Tin Whistle Tuesday. We have Rhode Island College information session here. For the theme for homecoming, we have the Jersey Shore versus Jersey Day. Whatever. Wednesday's the 23rd, Music Appreciation Club meets, Black Student Alliance meets, Local History is taking a field trip. UMass Boston will be here, and the American Sign Language Club meets with Miss Ochoa. The theme for Bulldog Block that day is Rhyme Without Reason, if you say so. Finally, on Thursday, we have the 24th. It's Board Game Club with Ms. Foster. Endicott College will be here, as well as Bridgewater State. So those are good opportunities for students. The theme for homecoming is West versus West Coast. Finally, on Friday, homecoming pep rally day. So how do we handle the day? We handle it with four academic classes right in the beginning of the day. So four, they're about 45-minute classes. So you'll go to block one, two, three, four for about 45 minutes each. Usually around middle of the day, we pivot to our homecoming preparations, getting ready for a 12:45 pep rally. So that's on Friday. And then Friday night, we've got our homecoming football game, and I'm sure you'll hear more about that from Mr. Carrig. We'll see you later.
What's up, Bulldog Nation? Happy homecoming week. It's Spirit Week here at school. We're looking forward to Friday night as we push through our Build the Nation campaign and work towards senior night for our football team and our dance team. It's going to be a great evening on Friday night with Dighton Rehoboth, so mark your calendars now. Get your tickets on GoFan and arrive early. We expect that one to be pretty busy. So get there early, get your tickets ahead of time, have that GoFan app ready to go. That's the culminating event this week, so let's put it up front. Today, let's talk about golf out in the Division II State Championship at Berkshire Hills out in Pittsfield, Massachusetts. Good luck to those six golfers out there competing for another run at a state championship after their Division II South Sectional runner-up performance last Tuesday. And congratulations on their SCC repeat championship in the SEC tournament at Allendale on Wednesday. Great job, fellas. What a season you're having, a perfect season so far. And good luck in the final event of your season, the D2 State Championship today. We'll have more information when we hear back from that tournament. Big news from Unified Basketball, a surprise perfect season banner unveiling on Friday. A great moment with a school pep rally. Thank you to all who attended and supported the team there. That was a great moment, and they remain perfect after another victory there against Dighton Rehoboth on Friday. They're home two times this week. They have Fairhaven on Wednesday, and then they'll also set the table for homecoming with a game on Friday. Football coming off a 39-6 win out at Greater New Bedford Volk Tech. Pretty dominant performance. These guys are rolling and look to do the same this Friday with Dighton Rehoboth coming in for a 6:30 start. We will be having Some halftime celebration recognizing our youth programs in town for football and cheer. We're looking forward to that. So lots to be excited about for Friday. Again, get here early. Parking's going to be a premium. It's going to be a very busy night. Girls soccer senior night is tonight, Monday, against Greater New Bedford Voke. They're avenging an earlier season loss and hoping to get that season series even on the year. It should be a really good night tonight at 7 o'clock following senior recognition for a really good bunch of girls playing soccer for us this fall. They're having a great season and looking to get into postseason form as the deadline approaches next week. Boys soccer coming off a tough loss on Saturday with Dighton Rehoboth. Looks to get back to normal business at Voke tonight, but they'll be at home. If you're looking for homecoming on-site festivities, they'll be home on Wednesday with Somerset Berkeley. That's a big one, and we'll need some fan support for that. So do show up, be loud, be proud, be positive, and come join us for Somerset Berkeley on Wednesday. Field hockey has finished their home season calendar with a tie, a win on Saturday with New Bedford, and they will be away Tuesday and Thursday this week. They have a showdown match with Seekonk on Thursday, the first of the SCC showdown matches for the year, and good luck to them as they finish up their regular season and look to punch their ticket to the postseason. Volleyball is looking forward to their SCC showdown game at Case on Thursday. That's the big one for them this week. They're home tonight, Monday, with Greater New Bedford Voke. So if you're planning to attend the soccer game tonight, join us for volleyball in the gym first, then head on out to the soccer game. Should be a beautiful night for both. Homecoming, dance tickets are on sale. If you're a student and you need to get your dance tickets, they're being sold at Bulldog Block in the main lobby. So get your tickets. And if you're getting tickets for that, get your tickets for the game on GoFan. I can't tell you enough times, get the tickets online, get there early, and be ready to be a part of a really great night of festivities on Friday night. Look for our postings on social media and through Facebook and emails going home. There'll also be a phone-a-thon on Thursday for Build the Nation. We are currently in the middle of our biggest fundraising campaign of the year. We need everybody's support, so if you can give a little. We appreciate it. It's necessary for us to be able to do what we do and provide everything we can for a really great group of athletes with all of our fall teams punching tickets for the postseason. So we appreciate your support at the field. Listen for more announcements on BTN, and we hope to see everybody on Friday night at homecoming. Go Bulldogs!
Thanks for the informative update.
Now it's segment time. First up, let's get a look at Jake's behind the scenes with the band.
One half year ago, the old Rochester Concert Band brought home the gold at their premiere performance.
Actually, it was bronze. We weren't that good.
They dressed to impress and beat out the rest. They were an unstoppable sonic force.
Dude, you're doing too much. We really didn't blow anyone away.
But time's arrow stops for no one, and the star performers graduated out, leaving in their stead a completely clueless set of freshmen with a deficit for attention. He was in for the challenge, his life.
These new kids, they just can't get it right. I tried everything. I took their laptops, I called their parents, I even hit one of them in the face.
He hits like all my people's out.
These two kids, they were the worst of them. Weren't even freshmen, but they set an example. They wouldn't stop bickering. They would pull pranks on each other. I'd really gotten sick of it. But this time, it got out of hand. I did my best to stop them, but it was just two against one. I knew I had to do something.
And something he did.
You're worthless! I can't tell what's worse. You're playing or you're hiding.
I really thought it was working, but I tried too hard, I guess.
The band was broken up.
I felt so awful. My stomach was churning from the anxiety. I knew exactly what I had to do.
He reported us to admin. He's such a fascist. God.
And so, the old Rochester band goes on with a strict martial discipline driving them, and an even stricter conductor.
The kids in the back, they're constantly on their phones, but do I complain? No, it was just that one time, but wait, how do you give me that?
Sounds great, guys.
Up next, Katie sits down with the new Latin teacher, Mr. McCarthy. Take it away.
Hello, I'm Katie, and today we're going to be interviewing our new Latin teacher. So what is your name?
David McCarthy, although I'm better known around these parts as Darth McCarth.
How long have you been teaching?
Too long. Over 30 years.
Wow.
On both the secondary and collegiate level.
What is your favorite thing about working at Old Rochester?
The kids. Kids are amazing here. Last year was when I was, subbing for Ms. Andrews. It was probably one of the best years I've ever had teaching. And why? It's the kids. So, even you. Yes. You didn't dissuade me from coming back here.
That's good.
So that's an achievement.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you do before coming to work at Old Rochester?
I taught at Silver Lake for 23 years, and before that I practiced law for 13 years, and before that I taught for 10 years, and before that I was in school.
All right. What made you want to teach?
I had a fantastic English teacher in ninth grade. He was the type of teacher who inspired people. He treated us like adults. And, after 8 years with the nuns, to have somebody treat you like an adult was different. So it was very inspiring.
Where did you go to college and what did you major in?
Well, I went to Wesleyan for my undergrad. And I majored in classics. Went to Indiana University right after my bachelor's degree and got a master's in classical studies. And then while I was teaching full-time during the day down at a high school in New Jersey, I went to law school at night at Rutgers. So I spent a lot of time in classrooms.
When did you first start learning Latin?
1968.
And why should a student take Latin?
Why should students take Latin? Well, it helps immensely with English vocabulary. The scientific, legal, medical terminology that we use today in English, most of it is derived from Latin. For years I taught a course at Quincy College and also at Silver Lake on medical terminology. 99% of medical terminology comes from Latin and Greek. So, you know, it was a long time ago that I started, and it's one aspect of why I think it's important to learn Latin is not only the help that it provides with English vocabulary, but every Latin sentence is a problem. Now, you know that, correct?
Yes.
Every single Latin sentence is a problem. Latin teaches analytical thinking skills. How do you approach a Latin sentence? Well, you have to break it down to its component parts, analyze the component parts, and then synthesize. And that's what analytical thinking, critical thinking is all about. So if you want to take a look at where students in medical school come from, what major they've had, the most successful on one end of the scale is those who took classics, Latin and Greek. If you want to take a look at students who have succeeded in getting admitted to law school, classics blows the other disciplines out of the water in terms of its success rates for its students. So if you want to go into law and want to go into medicine, then Latin is a pretty good course to take. I did medical malpractice for 13 years. And the only way I was able to do it was because of my knowledge of Latin and Greek. So it was an easy transition for me. For some of my colleagues who didn't have that background, it was much more difficult.
Have you ever visited Rome?
I lived in Italy for about a year. The first 6 months I lived in Rome. Then worked at a restaurant down in Anzio where the Americans landed in 44. And then I went back when I was in graduate school. My school decided to pay me money to go to Italy. And then I went back another time with my future wife, and then a fourth time I spent 2 weeks in Italy studying Catullus in preparation for the AP exams. Or in preparation to teach AP Latin for the exams. So I've been there. It's a wonderful place. You need to go. It's absolutely wonderful. You try to speak Italian, and the Italians love you for making the effort, as opposed to France. Anyway.
Do you have a favorite thing about Rome?
The people. You know, it's, they're warm, they're generous. You try to make an effort to learn about their culture and speak their language. They'll reward you in spades. And then, you know, in terms of sites, the Pantheon is the closest thing I've ever come to a religious experience, walking inside that building. It's absolutely amazing. It takes your breath away.
When did you start going by Darth McCarth?
Towards the tail end of my Silver Lake career. You know, I think that it's, you know, Latin can be kind of deadly, boring. You'll agree to that.
Yes.
So what do you have to do? You have to spice it up in a way. And so the Darth McCarth persona, I think, spices it up, especially when I have to correct a student. I go like that, and they're supposed to act as if they're being strangled. So, and that's from across the room. So, it's useful. You know, you got to have fun when you teach, because students respond well if they're relaxed and entertained. So that's my philosophy of teaching. So the Darth MacArth shtick plays into that.
Do you have a favorite Star Wars movie?
Empire Strikes Back. It's the most psychologically interesting. It really, there's so much in there. I've probably watched that one over 50 or 60 times because I teach Star Wars. And every time I see it, I discover something new. That's the hallmark of great art. And Lucas certainly is a great artist. Mm-hmm. So, good stuff.
And lastly, is there any life advice you would like to give to the graduating class?
Find something that you're passionate about. Find something that you're really interested in and you can imagine doing for the rest of your life, or for part of your life. You know, law I found to be interesting. I had a passion for it when I first started practicing, but by the end of my 13 years, I really didn't like it at all. I taught for 10 years before I went into the law. I enjoyed teaching, and when I decided to go back, it was the most rewarding experience. You gotta find something that floats your boat. You gotta find something that gets you out of bed in the morning. It's not an alarm clock. It's having a passion that, you know, you wanna go out and do a good job, so.
All right, well, thank you for coming on.
How riveting.
In our last segment today, let's join Sienna for an update on Spirit Week.
Hello, I'm Sienna Rovita, and I'm here with Student Council President Emily Wyman, and we are going to be giving you all the details on Spirit Days. All right, first up, we have PJ Day.
So, PJ Day, classic, just roll out of bed on Monday, show up, and it's usually great. We have a lot of people participate, so make sure to get comfy and start off the week strong with PJ Day.
Yep, you already know. Next, on Tuesday, we will have Jersey versus Jersey Shore. So make sure to gel your hair and wear your juicy tracksuits, or just in some sunglasses, or you can get your Celtics, Bruins, Patriots, or, yeah, jerseys out.
Yeah, or rep some ORR merch if you play field hockey, if you play football, anything. Yeah, big turnout this year.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then on Wednesday, we have Rhyme Without Reason.
Yeah, so this is a new one. This has been a TikTok trend. It's been something we've been trying to get into our Spirit Weeks for a while now. So essentially, just partner up with a person, one of your friends, or a group. Two things that are completely unrelated but rhyme. So, like,
we have, you can be a tree and a bee. Or you can be a fraternity brother and a maternity lady. Mother.
You could be Post Malone, Traffic Cone, list goes on. Look at TikTok for inspo. But yeah, we're excited to see how this new day plays out this year.
So exciting. Next, we have Thursday, which is West versus West Coast, where you can either be a cowgirl or boy or a surfer kind of vibe. And that's your choice for Thursday, so have fun with that. And then next we have class colors.
Yep, so every year on Spirit Day, for the pep rally on Friday, you can either come dressed up in your costumes for skit, which we love to see, or class colors to support your class, even if you're not in skit. So we have seniors are black, so wear your senior t-shirt. Juniors are red, sophomores white, and then the freshmen are gray. Yeah.
And if you're involved in skit, you can also wear your skit costumes on that Friday to show your spirit through that. And we just want to make sure that spirit is up next this week. And so you want to make sure to attend Friday's homecoming football game and make sure to buy your tickets for homecoming. It's going to be so fun.
Buy your tickets by this Friday. Tickets are $30 or $25 with a donation of socks as part of Community Service Club's Socktober. Also, make sure you follow ORR Stucco on TikTok and Instagram at Old Rochester Stucco to stay updated on all Student Council events.
Well, thanks for listening. I'm Sienna.
I'm Emily.
And that was your Spirit Days.
Smart stuff. Teachers and students, if you want something filmed and shown on Bulldog Weekly, let us know at the ORC TV station.
Be sure to check out our Vimeo and social media channels for everything we film here at ORC TV. We film sports games, town meetings, school events, and much more. Well, that wraps up this episode of Bulldog Weekly. Until next time, I'm Jake.
And I'm Katie. And this is Bulldog Weekly.